स्टैंडर्ड 6 सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 16 लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट पार्ट 1 वी ऑल हैव लर्न इन सेमेस्टर 1 इन चैप्टर नंबर 15 गवर्नमेंट दैट इंडिया इज़ अ डेमोक्रेटिक और रिपब्लिक कंट्री वेयर पीपल ऑफ द कंट्री इलेक्ट्स द मेंबर एंड दे वर्क फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द स्पेसिफिक एरिया ऑफ दैट कंट्री. In this chapter, we are going to learn about the local self-government, which works for the local area in which we are living. We all are aware of our government and types of government and level of government. Today, we are going to learn about local government of our area. Following paragraph has to be filled by us. I live in dash village or city. We have to write the name of our village or city in which we are living. There is a Gram Panchayat or municipality or corporation, that is municipal corporation, in my village or city. If you are living in village, then there is Gram Panchayat. If you are living in city, then there will be municipality or municipal corporation. The name of its head or sarpanch or president or mayor is dash. If you are living in village, then there will be sarpanch. And if you are living in city, then there will be president or mayor of the city. You have to fill the name of it. After fulfilling the details, it is understood that you live in a village or city. Try to find out the answer. You are aware of local administration system of your area. Now let's see how it works. Function means work. Local self-government, that is Panchayati Raj. Raj means rule and Panchayati means panch, where there are 5 minimum members who are administering the whole area. Local government works in 2 parts, village administration and city administration. In the village administration, there is village taluka and there is district. For example, I lived in Sukhpur village. Taluka is Bhuj and district is Kutch. Then there is city administration, there is municipality or municipal corporations. There are different rules whether there will be municipality or municipal corporation in city are decided according to these rules, which we are going to learn in later. First, we will learn about the Panchayati Raj. According to this, we can see a circle of local self-government which works for the rural area or local area. The pink part is village Panchayat, which works for a single village. Then the yellow part is for Taluka Panchayat. The village, all the villages which are included in one taluka, taluka panchayat will work for that taluka. For example, Bhuj taluka, all the villages which are included in Bhuj taluka, taluka panchayat will work for that, for all that villages. Then last or the bigger is blue line, that is district panchayat. District panchayat works for the whole district. For example, Kutch district. This panchayat will work for the whole Kutch. Panchayati Raj at village level, taluka panchayat at taluka level, and district panchayat at district level. Representative elected by the people at local level is called local self-government. Each and every people in this panchayat are elected by the citizen of that area. These institutions are called local self-government organization. Gram Panchayat, Taluka Panchayat and District Panchayat belongs to village local self-government, whereas municipality and municipal corporations are related to city level. Municipality works for the city, whereas Gram Panchayat, Gram means village. Taluka Panchayat and District Panchayat works for the village. Following fact shows that Panchayati Raj starts first in Bhagadra village of Nagaur district in Rajasthan on 2nd October 1959. Panchayati Raj was implemented from 1st April 1963 in Gujarat. According to the structure of government given in this page, the first and most basic step of this structure is Gram Panchayat. Village is the smallest part of a country. It is itself a village government. The second step is Taluka Panchayat. Third step is District Panchayat. Fourth is state government. And the most important and fifth is central government. Gram Panchayat will work for one gram or one village. Taluka Panchayat will work for one taluka. District Panchayat will work for one district. State government will work for one state. Whereas central government will work for the whole country. The District Panchayat is above the Taluka Panchayat. After the state government is there which runs the administration. Administration of Gujarat is carried out by the government of Gujarat, that is state government. Our country is governed by the central government. Thus, Gram Panchayat is the base of all the government. Gram Panchayat will inform the taluka. Taluka will inform the work about their functions to district. District informs to state government, and then state government will inform it to central government. First, we will learn about Gram Panchayat, how Gram Panchayat will form and which are the rules for the formation of Gram Panchayat. It is the most important unit in institution of local self-government. Gram Panchayat is composed in the village having population from 500 to 25,000. A village which has population from 500 to 25,000 are allowed to have a Gram Panchayat. There are minimum 8 and maximum 16 candidates elected on the basis of population. The head of Gram Panchayat is called Sarpanch. Sarpanch as well as other candidates of Gram Panchayat are elected after every 5 years. That means Sarpanch and their candidates have to work for 5 years for the development of the village. Voters elect Sarpanch through direct voting. Ward members are elected by the voters of the ward. In this way, Gram Panchayat of one village is formed. Now, administration, how the Gram Panchayat works. The Sarpanch and the member of Gram Panchayat together decides the work development by making resolutions on the development. Talati cum minister is appointed by the government. Talati is a government employee who works for the particular village where he is administered. She handles the administrative work, that means paperwork, collects the taxes from the villagers and makes reports of the Gram Panchayat and prepares forms and keeps the records of the budget. The office of Gram Panchayat is also called village secretariat. For the development of the village, Panchayat needs various resources or money. They will get this income from various taxes which is collected by the Talati. The first source of income for Gram Panchayat is water tax, cleaning tax, property tax and shop tax, which is paid by the villagers of that village. Second is the grant given by the state government and central government. State government and central government gives various grants or funds to the for the development of the villages, which is permitted by the panchayat for the development. Various works are done in the villages by the Gram Panchayat. First is to give the number to the houses. Second, arrangement of household and drinking water. The basic need of any human being is to get a shelter, a pure drinking water and food to eat. Then primary function is to make roads in the village, cleaning of village street and disposal of dirty water, maintenance of public property. Public property includes government offices, bus stations and various public schools, colleges, etc. Maintenance of health related facilities, that means to give medical facilities in the villages, lighting arrangement in the village, education facility including primary education in village. Primary education is compulsory education given to each and every child of the country without any discrimination. Planning of village development, maintenance of crops and pasture in the village, maintenance of land asset offices and maintenance of birth and death register. All these are the functions or works has to be done by the Gram Panchayat. Besides this, Gram Panchayat also held Gram Sabha, that is a meeting. In general language, Gram Sabha means to collect the villagers. A village meeting is like a legislative assembly where all the elderly people of village are considered as the member of Gram Sabha. They are supposed to remain present and have right to cast vote and even to put proposal. This meeting is held to discuss the various problems of the village and to give the solution about it. Gram Panchayat is required to organize Gram Sabha at least twice a year. The Sarpanch is the chairman of the Gram Sabha. Officers from Taluka and district level remain present in this meeting and the government employees of the village also remains present. Priority of development of work to be done by Gram Panchayat is decided. Village such as village road, drinking water, cleanliness, light, education and health are discussed and try to get solution for that. Each and every member of Gram Panchayat should be aware and remain present in Gram Sabha. The village problems and development work should be discussed and only transparent administration and purpose of Gram Sabha will be successful. In this way, Gram Panchayat work for a particular village and for the development of that village. In next part, we will learn about the work and administration of Taluka Panchayat and District Panchayat. Till then, you have to read the pages related to Gram Panchayat and try to solve all the answers of Gram Panchayat in your work. Thank you.